Good, so we're here with Karl Schilling from the University of Bonn. Mr. Schilling, could you please tell us a bit about your academic career and your current projects maybe, and how you got to be a professor at Bonn?
Yeah, so I started medicine originally, first in Brussels, Belgium, and then in Erlangen. After finishing those studies, I joined the Department of Pathology for about a year. There I got very interested in the cell biology, cell biology, and for that reason I joined the laboratory of Professor Pilgrim in Ulm at that time, who worked on the development of the nervous system. So that was a novel area for me, but a very interesting one. After 4 years in his laboratory, I went to the United States to the lab of Jim Morgan, who was then at the Roche Institute of Molecular Biology. That's close to New York City.
New Jersey, actually.
That's in New Jersey, yeah. Yes. But from where I lived, I could see the tip city. of the Empire State Building. Mm-hmm. So, after working for a little bit more than 2 years in his laboratories, I had a chance to go back to Ulm. I was appointed associate professor there. A couple of years later, I actually got an offer from the University of Bonn to join their faculty. And since then, I'm in Bonn in the Department of Financial.
That's great. Thank you very much. How did you come to be at the seminar today?
Well, as I said, we're working on developmental questions, and we're mostly working with cell culture models. But by the end of the day, you always ask, well, is this cell culture stuff you're doing really important for life? And so we're also doing animal models. And there again, by the end of the day, work on the nervous system. Everybody says having something to do with the function of the nervous system, and the function of the nervous system is best tested by looking at behavior. And so I collaborated a lot also with Chernobyl, who was here as a speaker, and that way I got into that field, and it seems that was the motivation for inviting me here. And, but I have to say, I learned a lot from this meeting.
Right. That's like the most important part, right?
Yeah,
exactly. And now for the last question, we have a kind of funny question for you. If you could choose to be any species you want, what species would you choose and why?
I think animal species?
Be anything.
Okay.
Maybe except human, because that would be...
Sure. That's a difficult one. I think I would like to be a wood-looking eye. Now, I know that you live in Germany. You may actually have heard what a wood-looking is. It's a fantasy animal made up of different parts for different animals. It has some fur, it has horns, it has different parts, but I think that why I selected this species, this non-existent, this fantasy species, is probably because it's, at least for me, it's very difficult of thinking being some other species. Mm-hmm. So it's actually what I wanted to say. It's not really possible for me to make a selection of that.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.